Brazilian staff, the life is going to change completely from this particular day. You've been chosen for an essential mission to protect an extremely dangerous and unpredictable object. Have you ever heard of SCP-354, the Blood Pond? Today we get you there all together to introduce containment protocol of the object. So, let's begin. You'll be able to ask questions later. The object was first discovered in the northern Alberta, Canada, by civilians who crashed on a passenger plane. According to the legend, this pond is a reservoir filled with human blood. Locals do believe that by means of the blood pond, some entities from the underworld are able to sneak into the world of ours. The Foundation reacted to the events as soon as it was possible and started their research. Since then, the object was named and its class was labeled as Cutter. At first, the object didn't display any activity, but Epsilon 38 unit, whose task was to patrol the location of the object, got forced to face SCP-354 true power. All of them are missing and dead. The reason of their death is classified. Then, the decision was made to create a full containment zone, which was the complex where you're heading very soon. In this zone, no activity has been noticed since the incident, but for the last 2 months. Abnormal magnetic conduction and emitting were observed with indicating devices. One of our scientists hypothesized that the object accumulates energy to eradicate a new creature, more powerful. Your task is to prevent its emergence or consequences. Have any questions?
Greetings! We're a small team developing a game about SCP-354 Redpool called SCP Invasion, and we'd like to present to you our project. It doesn't take much time. We have a development plan consisting of 3 phases. The first is a single-player horror game set in a large open location with a small storyline. The second is a multiplayer game about the confrontation between the SCP Foundation members and SCP objects at the Redpool location, where you can choose both sides to play. The third is to support the game and add new content. Our team prepares many unique gameplay features over each phase that you have not seen in SCP games before. Some of them will be presented in the video below, and now let us give you more information about these phases. Phase 1. Right now we are focused on the creating of a single-player prologue game that tells the story of Redpool SCP-354. Development has been going on for a year now, and we have something to show you. Location where the action takes place. The main antagonist and his main mechanics. Most of the gameplay mechanics of the main character, such as interaction with surrounding objects, inventory, shooting and movement. Interface and main menu. Model of probes, weapons, the inventory and exterior of the complex. Yes, you heard it right, the game will have a complex represented by several buildings. Concept art of other possible creatures. Single player campaign story and in-game soundtrack. Now let's talk more detail about our plans for the next phases of the development. Phase 2. Next, we want to implement a system of factions, Class D, Scientists, MTF and more from the official story of the SCP Foundation. There will be a confrontation between people and SCP objects, in an open locations with elements of horror and roleplay. People's mission is to capture or destroy SCP objects, perform additional tasks, when the mission of SCP will be to destroy people. We will use the best gameplay features from first phase to develop a high-quality multiplayer experience. Only with your financial support we will have the opportunity to gradually introduce new content. Every who supported us will receive preferences and bonuses in the game equivalent to their contribution to the project. Phase 3. If the second phase is successful, then we'll add new modes to the game and embody game situations and stories from this universe. And now a small FAQ. Why are we using Patreon? Isn't it easier to create a game and put it on Steam? Unfortunately, it takes a lot of time and effort to create a good game. It will take 2 to 4 years of working at least 6 people in the team. Game development is very expensive because of software licenses, graphics and audio editors, plugins, servers, websites. We have been working at a loss for a year and we will not survive with your financial support. This work is very difficult and that's why specialists in the game sphere have very high salaries. Game development is a technically challenging process. In other words, this is a total hell. This fact makes working on the SCP Invasion project very unprofitable and risky. That's why many SCP projects have been closed. No pain, no gain. Check out our Discord server, subscribe to our social networks to stay tuned. We will be glad to see you as a part of our community. A demo game is coming out very soon, with the mechanics that were described in this video. Do not miss it. Thanks for your attention. With your help, SCP will never die. Greetings. We're a small team developing a game about
must be dreaming away again. There. Don't panic. Inhale, exhale. Nothing happened. Everything's all right.
slow day. We seem to have an intruder in the area.
There. Don't panic, don't panic. Inhale, exhale. Nothing happened.
HQ, it's 59031. Do you copy? 59032 is found dead. We seem to have an intruder in the area.
Reading your clear, 59031. Move to 59042 location and wait for further instructions.
Massacre. 59042 are turned to pieces. They're even on trees. Please. level. Nobody told us. And that technician, by the way, you know, gone wild last week and attacked a crewmate with a screwdriver. Hell, there's something definitely wrong about that pod, I'm telling you. Maddening people and disabling electronics. That's a nice object for us to patrol, ain't it?
Who the hell's there? Don't panic, don't panic. Inhale, exhale. Nothing happened. Everything's alright.
HQ, it's 59031. Do you copy? 59032 is found dead. We seem to have an intruder in the area.
Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring.